they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethphage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this, 'The Lord needs them,' and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, 'Look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey and on a colt, the foal of a donkey.'" The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They bought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heaven." When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." I couldn't believe what I was seeing. This guy they called Jesus was riding into the city on a donkey, not on a horse, not in a chariot, on a donkey. They call him the prophet from Nazareth. They hailed him as if he were a king. I couldn't believe what I was seeing, but I hailed him anyway. "Hosanna to the Son of David." And let us pray. Holy God, help us to recognize the one you sent. Help us follow even when the crowds return home. Amen.
Amen.
Then one of the 12, who was called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said, "What will you give me if I betray him to you?" They paid him 30 pieces of silver. And from that moment, he began to look for an opportunity to betray Jesus. Forgive us, God, when we let what we want get in the way of what you want. Amen.
On the first day of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus saying, "Where do you want us to make the preparations for you to eat the Passover?" He said, "Go into the city to a certain man and say to him, 'The teacher says, my time is near. I will keep the Passover at your house with my disciples.'" So the disciples did as Jesus had directed them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When it was evening, he took his place with the 12, and while they were eating, he said, "Truly, I tell you, one of you will betray me." And they became greatly distressed and began to say to him one after the other, "Surely not I, Lord." He answered, "The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of Man goes as it is written of him, but woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born." Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Surely not I, Rabbi." And he replied, "You have said so." While they were eating, Jesus took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to the disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink from it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will never again drink of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." When they had sung the hymn, they all went out to the Mount of Olives. It means so much to me that these men and women are willing to gather with me as the authorities close in. I know they will stumble, and I know they are doing the best that they can. It's getting late. Time to move on. God, you have sent me to show the way. I need you to be with me now. This is getting harder every step. Amen.
Then Jesus said to them, "You will become deserters because of me this night, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will scatter.' But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "They'll all become deserters because of you. I will never desert you." Jesus said to him, "Truly, I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. Peter said to him, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you." And so said all the disciples. "Hey, Jesus, good guy, you're back. All of us there, you can count on us, really." Let us pray. Oh God, give us the strength to keep our promises. Amen.
them to a place called Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee and began to be grieved and agitated. Then he said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and stay awake with me." And going a little further, he threw himself on the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet not what I want, but what you want." Then he came to the disciples and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter, "So, you could not stay awake with me 1 hour? Stay awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." Again he went away for the second time and prayed, "My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done." Again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them, he went away and prayed for the third time, saying the same words. Then he came to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand." I knew we should stay awake, but it's been such a long week. Just a few days ago, the crowds were shouting and waving branches and throwing their coats on the ground to greet Jesus. The next day, we were in the temple, chasing out the money changers. All week long, Jesus has been speaking about the end, and none of us want to hear it. I'm just so worn out. I know we should stay awake, but I'm overcome. God in heaven, we have seen this one show us the way. We have struggled to understand. We have struggled to follow. Give us the strength to carry on. And when we fall short, forgive us.
At that hour, Jesus said to the crowds,
"Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day, I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But all this has taken place so that the scriptures of the prophets may be fulfilled." Then all the disciples deserted him and fled. For so many years, we just kept our head down, hoping the Romans wouldn't notice us. And then, in the blinking of an eye, we're surrounded by the authorities. They've come to take Jesus. He kept saying they would do this. We didn't believe him. He said the answer was not in fighting back. We didn't believe him. He said the answer was in loving, not fighting. I am overwhelmed. We pray. God, give us the courage to return to the work that you call us to. Give us the patience and tenacity to stand with Jesus and all those who are threatened by the laws of those in power. Forgive us when we fall short. Amen.
Thank you. nothing speaks like the text. This is one of those days. Our being willing to live through this text makes it more likely that we will truly live our lives this day. Our being able to live through this text reminds us why we walk with Jesus, why we are committed to justice, why we care about what's going on in the world. Living this text gives us that courage. I hope that all of you will be with us on Good Friday. I know that all of you cannot be. And if you're not able to be with us, I invite you to read the text. We've listed it in the bulletin today. It continues the Gospel.